Okay. Great. I want to just do been in business for 10 years now. When I moved into my big salon, which is just across the street, I needed to get aligned with a company that I thought would take me to the next level. And that company was STX. You know, I run all my business with Apple Computers. And the founder of STX, John Maple, is here today. He's filming it because he is actually a hairdresser. So again, it's a salon software system that has been designed by a hairdresser, so a hairdresser actually understands what we do, because he's one of us. And he's built a brilliant company called Salon Transcripts, okay? And I bought into that about 8 years ago. And the best thing about it is, some of the things that we're doing in business now, John Maple actually and his design team have helped to design special things that work for Arojo. For example, I've asked John to design me a rewards program because I wanted to have a rewards program for my salon. He designed that. I asked John to design for me my priority booking spreadsheet. So with one finger, I can get an analysis of my business week to week to see who the performers are and to see where we need to push, you know, people in the right direction to gain more success. They wrote that for me. They have just wrote a special Arojo app that goes onto the iPad, another tool that really has been very influential in how we have grown our business. So they're going to be presenting tomorrow the new Arojo app, which can actually help you prescribe products and provide them for your clients. So I'm really thrilled that they're here. I want to give them a big round of applause. I know tomorrow afternoon, you got to come by, see this app in action, and see what John's got to say. Because at the end of the day, the things that STX have done for me have helped my company grow. And by the way, one of the keys to my success is always, you know, I look at other mentors that maybe I don't get to talk to, you know, but Steve Jobs has been a big influence in our lives, and certainly for me with what he's done with Apple, you know, what he created, you know, he really was a true visionary. And for me, he's been a real inspiration. And we've kind of modeled our brand as much as possible because it's about simplicity and effectivity. And that's something that I'm going to continue to drive forward with because I believe that we do have to create new things all the time. And we need to be completely connected to technology so that we can create success. Because I'm a salon owner that works behind the chair too. I still do clients every week. I'm right behind the chair. I'm in the trenches on the salon floor. And that's where I love it. I love the energy and the buzz. Yesterday in my salon, it was phenomenal to see so many chairs filled and hairdressers looking great. And we had the Goldwell and the KMS team, you know, working on the other side in the school. You know, there's a thing called about energy. Energy, you can't take a picture of energy. You know, you can't take a photograph of it. It's what you feel. And the one thing that I love more than anything is the feel of the energy in my salon. It's that buzz factor. You know, and I really love that. That's why I always say, my door's wide open, come in anytime. I'm welcoming all the time. Busy creates busy. And that's something that I really believe. So please, you know, again, just another secret to some of the things that have helped to make me successful. Okay, I think we got a slide to put up there, Christine, yeah? Because I have a special announcement, okay? I have a special announcement to make. Because I've got two great salons that have been on the Arojo choo-choo train for a very long time. And these two salon owners are really dear to my heart. I'm going to talk first about Salon in Maryland, Daryl Barrett. Now, Daryl, I met Daryl many, many years ago. He's got his team here. And he bought into the Arojo brand and the message. He was one of the first to buy in to the brand and the message. He didn't have a salon, but you know what he had? He had a dream. And he said, Nick, I just want to, you're inspiring. I want to be a part of what you're doing. I want to support you. And we've connected and we've stayed constantly connected. And he has built, now he has, he's in his second salon. He had his first location. He's expanded to his second location. And 2 weeks ago, he got his whole team certified in American Wave. And now his new vision is to become completely aligned with Arojo and with Goldwell, and he's going to be a true ambassador. So please give his team a big round of applause. I'm really thrilled to have you guys' support. I know Goldwell are too, and we're going to make success together. Now let's talk about Richard, the Richard Salon, okay? Because the Richard Salon from Long Island is amazing because this guy created a salon and came to see me about a year ago. We met in Chicago. And he's just a, you know, when you meet people and you just know how nice and genuine and honest and open they are. And he's just always very receptive to the focus of success. He wants to be successful. Well, he is a Salon 200, top salon of the Salon Today magazine. He's a top 200 winner. He's really proud of his achievements. We've been working together for the past 14 months since we met in Chicago. And his salon is going from strength to strength. And he also is making that big commitment to become a flagship salon, just like Daryl. I'm really thrilled to have him. His team are at every Happy Mondays. When you're in New York or you're in the area, you can send your team in for Happy Mondays. It's the first Monday of every month in my studio. Free education and inspiration because you're part of our family. His team comes with him. I've gotten to know his team personally, and I've gotten to witness and experience the growth in that salon. And only a couple of weeks ago, I got into my car, and I drove out there, myself and Gordon, and we went to hang out with him. And I just want to give his team a recognition and a big round of applause too, please. Thank you. And guys, we're just going to continue to go from strength to strength. That's what we're going to do because I'm committed to you. I'm committed into growing, helping you grow your business. And, you know, SDX is another company that, you know, if we align ourselves, we can learn from each other and grow with each other. And that's like one of the things I always say is I never live in fear. I just stay focused on one thing. The number one key to success, to my success, is one word, education. That's why we are an education culture company. And what you've experienced today so far is education in all aspects of what we do as a craft. So we don't want to just be in one place. We want to be across the whole realm. So for our final presentation, we have three artists on stage. We have two people from my team, and we also have a special guest from California. So, we're gonna watch a video for our next editorial presentation, and then I am gonna introduce you to our inspirational editorial team for our last presentation of the day. Thank you.
And again the night, see night.
Okay, so please welcome onto the stage from New Jersey, Cheryl Fazio, and from California, Tim Duanes, two key members of the Orojo artistic team. Come on, Tim. And Cheryl. All
right. Hello.
Hello.
All right. It's working. Sunday fun day. All right.
Did you guys get some mimosas yet? Not yet. Oh, man. I would have been hammered by now. Just kidding.
So I'm super excited to share with you our concept. We use New York City as our playground, as you can see on the video. We shot in Bryant Park. We shot in Chinatown, in Times Square, 42nd Street, because we wanted those heavily populated areas so we can get that voyeuristic kind of view of somebody going outside the system, you know, somebody that looks like an outsider. And in turn, you kind of, when you watch the video, you kind of feel a little awkward, maybe like a little bit intrigued at the same time, sort of just like, what just happened? You know, what did I just watch?
And what am I on?
Yeah, and what am I on?
Or what were we on? That's the question.
We wanted to create that feeling.
So, Cheryl, what are you going to do for us right now?
Well, I actually set my model Alex's hair with pin curls, a modern take on a pin curl set, all going forward and then all going back and just being really kind of technical with that. And I'm going to show you guys the move, which is a technique that I created for a basis and a foundation for event styling. I'm really into event styling and wedding hair. So this technique is just going to allow you to make it last all day.
And Cheryl in the salon does a lot of styling. So she really knows how to turn something that is editorial into something that is maybe a little bit more consumer friendly. And Tim, what's your concept?
So I believe in elegance. I believe in beauty. I don't like my girls walking around like they're crazy looking. I like them to look beautiful in one way, shape, or form. So I always try to transform a classic into something that is a little bit more than a classic. So I've gone through and micro-crimped Julia's hair here, and I'm going to create a French twist underneath with a nice soft kind of finger wave on top. Just like haircutting, you want to create a foundation. And if you don't know your basic techniques, you're not going to be able to go crazy with it. So I'm coming through back combing. I micro crimped everything below the rounds of the head. And then above the rounds of the head, I set everything using an inch barrel curling iron. Just creating that shape. And then, you know, interpreting the video. Like the video, what we did, we wanted to create a feeling of a monster turning into something beautiful. So we put the editorial before, because she's on the outside, you're looking at her like, what's going on? And then towards the end, she kind of transitions into a really nice, beautiful, you know, elegant woman going through Times Square, which is a nice lit up kind of space. So I'm kind of translating that into here, coming through and backcombing my underneath to set up for my French twist.
Excellent. Okay, now it gives me great pleasure to welcome creative director for KMS and a very dear friend of mine, Mr. Brian Bode. Please give him a big round of applause.
Hello, how is everybody today? So my take right now, I've been on a little four-week journey traveling all over the world, actually, and I've been doing so much photo work and fashion shows and runway work. And, you know, what I see right now is just this multiple texture going from smooth to beautiful curls. You know, you look at what's going on out there in the world and you know, in the financial world, people are having a really hard time. And, you know, a couple years ago, we were seeing hair that was just very deconstructed, really big shapes. So my concept today is to keep it very, I want the curls to be very soft, very formed. So what I did is I went in with a flat iron. I used a little bit of NYX dry shampoo, just very slightly. I didn't use too much product in her hair. I took a flat iron, just kind of working the hair into it to get me this S shape. I went in with three different size curling irons, and now I'm just going to kind of go through and just kind of build the shape. And again, I think that's what's really important, is just to really start training your eye, looking at all types of art, architecture, you know, what's happening, and try to figure out how you can take those shapes, bring them into the hair that you're going to do. So how I try to keep these curls not so deconstructed is I just will start to take the curl and just start to work it a little bit. And you can see that as I separate these curls, I can start to build the shape. I'm not getting a really frizzy look. I'm just getting very, very soft, soft curls. And not using too much product. Like I said, I just wanted to use a little bit of the dry shampoo just to give me a little bit of texture in the hair. So I'm just going to keep going through here and start to build out this shape, keep it really natural, and then have most of my texture through here.
Great, Brian. And Brian is also was my very first ambassador. And we met, and we, you know, as a creative director now for KMS, he's got a very successful salon called Oya in California. It's in Monterey.
The team's out there, yeah, somewhere.
Team's here in the house, which is great. And... And again, we just become very good friends because, again, it's about sharing what we do and about staying connected. And it's great to have him here, and it's a real pleasure seeing your work, Brian. And we actually did Happy Mondays in Monterey, California, too. And that was a lot of fun, and that was in January. So, Cheryl, it looks like you're working pretty hard now. Now, you came up with this idea called The Move.
I did. I just wanted, whether you've been doing event styling for years or whether you're just beginning, I wanted a place to start. I wanted some basis and foundation to build upon. And The Move, you can expand it or add to it, or there's countless ways to build upon. But I wanted a starting point because foundation is so important in hair cutting and coloring and 100% in hairdressing. And because these styles have to last sometimes 9 hours, I want my girl to be like doing the walk of shame the next day at the brunch and still have my updo in, okay? I want them to be like, you look good, but I know what you did last night. So this Move is sort of like a base, you know, a base and foundation. You know, how does that... You know, editorial and event styling, the gap is closing pretty, you know, it's closing, and people don't want, there's not a separate category anymore. Like, people want the runways. They're taking inspiration from a runway for editorial and event hair. So it's pretty amazing to take inspiration from runway now and have somebody go out on the town and look amazing.
So is this it? Are we going to see The Move?
We are. I am teaching The Move tomorrow. During the styling class, but I'm going to do a quick kind of, I need you to kind of turn a little bit this way. Now, I'm going to do it on the side. So it's basically, it's really quick. You can do it in like 2 seconds. But you want to keep your hand towards your chest. You want to wrap, you want to wrap the tail around so it's, again, towards your chest. You want to twist. You want to get your pinky out and kind of grab that end. And then this way, turn a little bit, you can either spread this apart or you can add to it, and all these soft curls can kind of form over it, building upon this. So it gives you like a starting point.
So that was the move.
That's the move. It's quick.
That's the move.
It's quick and easy, and you can do it on countless updos. So, yes. Here,
once is a magic trick, twice is a magic lesson.
Okay. So you want to take your hand. You want it to always, go towards your chest. You could do this. I'm doing it on the side right now. You could do it anywhere on her head to build any kind of updo. And then you want to wrap it around. So the tail end is towards your chest. You want to twist. Don't let go of both, things, the bun and then you want to grab your pinky and kind of lock it in and then pin around your hand so that you don't really have to do any like fancy moves. You just have to do the move.
Yeah. So no fancy moves, just the move.
And I've taught it to so many people in the salon, especially people who are just starting out, and it's helped them out so much. At least they know, there's a plan. They're not just like, oh my God, how do I get that to look like that? A lot of loose updos need that foundation. Anybody can make hair look loose, but can it stay for 9 hours, So this is, it's kind of creates like that pack, that foundation that you can kind of build upon.
So that's your base.
That's the base.
Perfect. Okay, Tim, how's it going? Looks like you've changed it radically, quickly. We were too busy watching the move, and you was doing your own move.
So I've gone through, I put my French twist in, and then I've created this nice soft shape out of my set up front. I always like to kind of come around, check the balance, make sure it doesn't look too alien shaped. Sometimes you'll see that French twist walking down the road, and you're like, what happened? She has a growth off the back of her head. So I always think of my geometry as a graduated bob, and that just kind of sets me in. So the weight distribution falling straight in through into her jawline. So even though it's an exaggerated shape, I got a nice shape going down and through her jaw. And I've combed out the top, and I'm just kind of playing with it and placing it on top and molding the hair around, playing with my texture, creating a really feminine shape, but something that's a little bit more exaggerated. So the difference between an editorial shape and an event shape would be something just a little bit more extreme. And that's what I wanted to do over here. Just giving myself a little bit of extra pinning, checking things out, spraying a little refinish. And the beauty of mine is it doesn't have to last all day. It can last for an image, or it can last for a catwalk, and then I could change it. I do a lot of runway styling. I lead a lot of shows. I did 17 shows this last season, and I keep myself pretty busy, and I've been spearheading a program through the studio as well, getting our young stylists involved and trying to create that buzz around Fashion Week. And it's been really fun. I really like to see people go for their first show, get the jitters, and then get into it and see how it goes for them.
And if you're interested, part of our program with our ambassadors is we actually want to start creating the opportunity for you to come and work on Tim's team.
Yeah,
so exactly. Fashion Week comes up in the fall. We're going to be starting to open that door. And if you're interested in coming to be a part of the, you want to have that Fashion Week experience, then Tim is definitely spearheading that. And that's something that, put yourself out there and make it happen. And it's nothing better than telling your clients that you've experienced Fashion Week. It's great.
Exactly.
Cheryl, that looks awesome.
Thanks.
Seriously.
So I love molding. To the individual. I mean, I do so many weddings a year and event styling. I do about 30 a year. And I love, working with somebody and, forming something together, using their individual style and really making kind of like a modern take on classic shapes.
So. And you pinned everything into the move?
I pinned everything into the move. I'm going to do this real quick so you could see that you're not seeing the actual packing, but, it's in there. And if you wanted, there's so many possibilities. You can spread it so that it's more dramatic. You can hide it and not see it at all. But it really gives you that foundation that you can, it can look loose and airy, but it will stay. That's what the trends are going now for bridal hair. It's all about, they just want to look like they threw it up. Well, okay, give me $250 and I will just throw it up for you. So
we'll give you. You said you'll throw up all over.
She is from Jersey.
$250 and you'll throw up all over.
No,
genius.
Genius.
So are you ready?
I am ready. I am ready.
So what we're going to show you is we're going to transition our models. Her taking her event, I'm going to bring it over here. I'm going to turn it into something completely different using the foundation that Cheryl put in place. And she's going to do the same here, transition this into something more wearable for daytime, showing you that just the base can be the same. You can use the same set. It's all in the shape. So here's our first look.
Okay, I'm going to switch her. I'm going to switch
her. All right, girls, go ahead and switch.
Okay. Switch.
So you can see I just... lightly kind of went through, built up some shape, you know, and just really paid attention to her own texture. I'm really big on just kind of working with the model, working with who I am, not trying to create anything that wouldn't work for her, you know. And just very soft and just a really great shape. And now I'm going to go ahead and change her up as well.
So it's important to, oh, sorry, go on, give him proud.
Yeah.
It's important to keep things loose if you're doing something that's not going to stay just for a shot. So say if you're just doing a shot, less product is more, and just being really good with your pinning, making sure you're using the right pins for the right situation, being able to take something down and change it on the fly is a really nice skill. So if you have your foundation in place, you can do that. You can create a really versatile, wearable look. And it's kind of, you know, it's fun. It's fun. I like that this texture is here. Cheryl and I had a lot of discussion as to what we were going to do and how we were going to be able to pull this off and have it wearable. And, you know, I dreamt about it all night last night that things are going to go horribly wrong and I would try to take it down. She'd be bald. And I was kind of freaked out. I saw some pictures of Alex here after the video with, like, bright blonde hair because she's the girl from the video. And I was like, oh, no, did she cut it? If she cut it, we're screwed. What are we going to do? So, you know, just thinking on your toes, being able to create those shapes and create a nice foundation. So I'm going to go through, and I'm actually going to create a video or a look similar to the video that we did where it was all expanded out. I like to use unconventional tools. So for this, I'm using coat hangers as my structure for Alex's expanded shape, but still utilizing, you know, very technical ponytail execution. It's something that I will be getting into tomorrow with the editorial class. I will show you how to utilize the coat hangers and play around with different objects that you can find around the house and making them into something that maybe you wouldn't think of.
Yeah, and I mean, I think what you're saying is so true with the product. I mean, this is a perfect example. If I would have used a lot of product in this, I would have been stuck. And if you're doing editorial work and you're working in front of a camera, the product usage has to be so important, and you got to really think about the diversity and how to change things up, because a lot of times you think you're going in doing something, and then all of a sudden it changes. And if you've put too much hairspray in it, and you're out in the middle of the desert somewhere.
That goes the choo-choo train.
Sorry. That's the desert. Boop, boop.
They're coming for you, Brian. They're coming for you.
I
you've
know.
Been traveling
they
all
follow,
over.
They follow me all
you've
around.
You've been traveling all over the place for KMS. Now, how's that as a salon owner and working with a brand? What have you been up to? What's your game plan? What are you doing?
Well, I mean, it's been an amazing experience because I've been in Germany doing a lot of product development, working with a lot of just what's coming out in the next few years with KMS, and I love that aspect of what I do. I have a degree in design, and I went to the Art Center in Pasadena, and you know, that degree has helped me sort of branch out. I've been a hairdresser my whole life. My family created Sebastian, so I've been traveling a long time, and that's just what I love to do. The salon element of it, I think, is the support. It's having a really great team that can support you. It's really great to know that I can tell my clients I'm going to be gone, and I can, you know, very easily hand them to one of my junior stylists and know that they're going to have the great quality service that they would have with me. So I think it's all about education. It's all about your team and just trying to be home as much as possible, you know?
Definitely.
Well, it's looking great. Now, Tim, this is really pretty avant-garde.
Yeah, you know, I'm building a really wide shape. I'm utilizing an elastic to hold down a hanger that's creating a nice rigid shape. So I use the hanger as part of the hair in my ponytail just to anchor it down. This gives me a really moldable
look, I can change it in like 2 seconds to any shape I want. I can get like 5-6 different looks out of just one look. So it's kind of fun. I always like to just change it up a little bit. I'm going to just deconstruct this and then attach it. And then that's pretty much it. Drop a little bit of hair over the front. So keeping it really simple, again, overcomplicated usually turns into a mess. So the simpler you can keep it, the better it's going to be and the longer it's actually going to last for your model and for your shoot. So I really like to not overcomplicate my shapes. So I'm come through here and kind of attach some of this hair with a little bit of an elastic on the end of my hanger, if it goes through. Brian, that looks awesome, dude. So Brian and I had a little heart-to-heart yesterday about what he was going to do, and he was right on trend. We were like eye for an eye. We knew exactly what was going to go on and how to create really, really, really something that was cohesive based off of what he was into and what Cheryl and I were into and what we had been doing with our shoots. So that was really, really cool to see that we're on the same page. You know, the trend is consistent across the board. Cheryl, yeah, what you got going?
That was pretty amazing, actually. We showed me the video, and we were doing prep yesterday, and it was just, it's great when it happens like that.
When it just, like, falls together, you know, which a lot of times that happens if you're, like, working with people that you kind of, like, have, you know, spoke to a little bit, you know, you're like-minded. That's always a really, really fun thing to get involved with.
Tina did the styling, one of our apprentices. She made the dresses.
She reinvented tulle today.
Yeah, seriously.
And it's seriously, she made couture dresses out of tulle, which, you know, I think are beautiful. You know, she's amazing. Yes. Both hairstylist and regular stylist.
Yeah, she's
can't forget
insane.
She does hair too.
But she just like pulled it out the box. We're like, we want something crazy and kind of flowy and ethereal, but the makeup's going to be really creepy and the hair's going to be really big. So how do we do that? And Tina was like, oh, I got you guys. And then she just came up with this idea, and we were like, oh, that works? You could do that?
Is she cool. here? Or is she back working? Tina, come up here. Come on stage. Come on. So I want everyone to see who you are.
Woo!
I'm going to pull you up on stage. Can you make it? Oh, yeah. Now, Tina went to my cosmetology school, too, and she used to be the assistant to Betsy Johnson. Is that right? She did tech design for Betsy Johnson. Set design, yes. Technical design, which is what?
Just basically start to finish off something
made, measurements. Awesome. Awesome. And she styled our show for us last week at the New York IBS, and there's a special show tomorrow night. What is that, Brian, tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night we are going to be out at the Wharf. We're going to be doing a kind of like a VIP event for Goldwell, Arojo, and also KMS. So it's going to be a great event because we've been putting it together for a while.
Yeah, and Tina's going to be styling the Arojo. Again, you know, it's part of, you know, being hairdressing. You can do hair, but you can do vision, you can do clothing, be creative. And we really encourage that. Something that I really encourage. Get everybody involved and really encourage them to be successful. And if they want it, then they'll make it happen. And if they don't, then somebody else is going to step up and take over. So that's what we do. So great job, Tina. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Tina.
I see a lot of Tina. She's such a creative young individual.
Okay. I mean,
finishing words, Brian?
So, yeah, if I could just say anything about doing editorial work, it's stay as, just really understand the hair you're working on. A lot of times I'll just put my model, I'll prep my model a couple days before, let her go home and sleep on it, and then come back and really work with just her natural texture and really try not to use over product. I think the biggest thing I see out there is hairspray and hairspray and hairspray and too much over product. And I think you just have to be really careful when you're doing that. And really pay attention to shape and contrast. But I love this look. I love using the powder. You know, it just kind of gave me a little tacky, makes the hair really, really dry, and it just kind of blends in with our theme. Beautiful work, man.
Thanks, you too, Tim. Buddy. Me too. So this is our inspiration, White Outsider, Cheryl and I's little creation. Thank you so much for sitting through it and hanging out with us, guys.
Yep. Cheryl, any final words?
Yeah, thank you so much for, you know, being here and letting us share our concept with you. It was so inspiring. I just got inspired just by being in New York City and seeing it the way I do. I mean, I'm from Jersey, so I don't see it the way a lot of other people see it. So being in Times Square and all those busiest areas having their cell phones out, and it was just really inspiring, and working with these two is always inspiring. So whether you're doing event hair or editorial, they're not that different the way that you go about it. So don't be scared to do either one. All right.
Exactly. Please give Tim, Brian, and Cheryl a big round of applause. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys, very much.
Great job. Thank you. Thank you, ladies. Awesome
thank you.
Job.
You can come on.
Thank you. Great job.